StarCraft is so much more than just a video game. It has a lot of really incredibly intelligent, very competitive people. It's a social experience. The people I've met through it, the places I've been because of StarCraft, you can never just call it a game. It's really molded my life.
My first exposure to StarCraft was actually in 1999. We didn't know what this was. It was something totally new. It was that game that was kind of like Warcraft, just let's play it. But it was new, it was different, and it was fun.
New World opened up to me. Something I had no idea existed, and it captivated my attention from the very beginning.
It was all about curiosity. What can I do with this game?
I really like the competitiveness. Everything rides on the single player.
In my opinion, it's the hardest game in the world.
I play it every day, and when I was sleeping, I can dream about StarCraft 2. When I woke up, so I want to play StarCraft 2.
It's mental MMA. It's real-time chess.
It's about finding that gradual improvement, finding the little victories, and sometimes it's just about having fun.
StarCraft의 재미를 세 개의 단어로 표현하려고 생각을 하는데, 첫 번째는 인생이라고 생각을 하고요. 두 번째는 우정, 세 번째는 재미라고 생각을 합니다.
Existem duas coisas muito importantes na vida. Uma delas é vencer, outra é se divertir. Busque sempre o equilíbrio para isso. Isso StarCraft te ensina.
One of the beautiful things about StarCraft is there's a social experience around it.
StarCraft really made me meet friends that were from different places. And that kind of made me realize that there were people that didn't have to be from where I am to like the same things that I liked.
You can get to know people from all over the world. You can interact with people from all over the world.
The game is always a very common language that we can share.
Przede wszystkim jest to niesamowite uczucie, jeżeli jesteś członkiem tej olbrzymiej społeczności, którą tworzymy przez Networks.pl, która pozwala nam po prostu, która zrzesza.
在台湾来说的话, 长大的时候就是现在这么陪伴着我, 然后我们到现在都还持续着玩, 并且关注着游戏, 甚至可能他们不玩了, 可是他们还是会看比赛。
The Australian StarCraft community is very, very tight-packed and very friendly to be around.
StarCraft 2 specifically and StarCraft Brood War in Korea really shaped a lot of the esports scene. StarCraft Brood War kind of showed the world what esports could be.
StarCraft 한국에서 인기 있었던 거는 물론 게임이 굉장히 잘 만들어진 것도 있지만은 그때 당시에 어떤 문화를 이끌어가는 어떤 역할을 했었던 것 같아요, 스타크래프트는.
StarCraft foi o pai de todos os esportes. Nada acontecia antes disso. Tudo aconteceu depois de StarCraft.
I think that when I first started really getting involved in the community was when I started watching a lot of esports. It was back then the beta tournaments and eventually the MLG tournaments. It's very weird, but now that I think about it, I never really felt like that with any other game.
StarCraft is a way of living, because even if you play it for a little period of time, it's gonna change how you see the world.
Yeah, so I have a 12-year-old. His name is Mini Wheat, and he was definitely introduced to StarCraft at an early stage. For me as a parent, it was quite fascinating because I was like, wow, okay, six-year-olds don't have urgency, you know, they will take forever to build. So it was awesome as a parent to kind of see that.
I would say my first great memory was winning the first WCG Pan American, because I was winning the first gold medal for our country. It was a really big step for the esport. If a Chilean player can win stuff, maybe we can win stuff too. It was the start of something that changed my life.
일단 제 성격 자체가 사실은 굉장히 조용조용하고 어떻게 보면은 약간 프로토스랑은 정반대로 약간 어떻게 보면 좀 소심한 면도 있거든요. 근데 오히려 게임이라서 가능했던 것 같아요. 그 게임에서는 내가 실제로 하지 못했던 어떤 내가 실제로 가지지 않은 면을 어떻게 다르게 보여줄 수 있다는 면이 있어서 어떻게 보면 제가 가지지 못한 거를 게임으로 해석했다고 볼 수도 있을 것 같아요.
I identify with Kerrigan, who is the lead of the Zerg race. I think it's amazing to have a strong female character in the center of the StarCraft universe. She's not a secondary character, she's actually the main character that carries the story along.
All my best friends I've met have actually been through StarCraft. StarCraft has done so much for me.
We talk about StarCraft daily now. Sometimes we talk about players, tournaments.
Noi parliamo di StarCraft a cena, parliamo di StarCraft quando siamo tutti insieme. Diciamo, StarCraft ormai è diventata la nostra quotidianità.
So StarCraft has played an incredibly influential role in my life. I think as a competitive game, it really formed me to be self-critical, motivated, competitive, and I did a lot of things that I think developed me as a person. And basically all of the things that I do today in some way are related to me finding that game back when I was 14.
StarCraft가 제 인생을 아예 다 바꿨어요. StarCraft 하나만으로 직업 그리고 친구들 그것뿐만 아니라 주변에 있는 환경마저도 다 바꿔버렸는데
It made me like a different person, I would say. Like a person that always have a goal in mind and wants to reach it anyways, like never surrender. That's a point of view that I didn't have before.
In 2007, got into a place where I was one of the people to qualify for the finals of WCG USA, but still being a poor college student, I didn't really have the means to send myself to Florida, so I kind of just gave up on it. But my mom, who knew that this was that important to me, who also didn't have any money, actually skipped her rent that I later found out to send me there. And as history would have it, I go there, I win, and then, you know, StarCraft becomes my actual profession forever. It started with me wanting something and my family believing in it. I can't do anything but think that StarCraft is the reason that I'm here today.
StarCraft é a vida como ela é. Isso é uma coisa que é um jogo que passou de uma geração para outra. Isso é sensacional. Eu duvido que muitos jogos jogados hoje passem de uma geração para outra.
Że to nie jest tylko zabawa dla dzieci, to jest coś bardzo, bardzo ważnego. To jest ogromna część życia i ogromna część
nas.
I think it will last forever.
In the next 20 years, StarCraft would still be in the hearts of minds of the people that it has touched in the last 20 years.
You're talking about a game that was basically a giant piece of clay. And every single time that a player played it on a professional level or a tournament organized the play of all of these folks, this clay was being molded. And even to this day, it is still being tweaked into this masterpiece that is not yet complete and may never complete. But that's it. That's the magic. It keeps molding. It keeps changing. And for that reason, why would I ever stop loving this game?